Hello, I'm Mobilent. We're going to start producing large battery packs for electric bicycles. Let's first explain the battery's basic electrode polarity. The top side is the positive plus electrode, while the bottom side, including the battery surface cylinder, is negative. Now, let's talk about the battery manufacturing procedure. First, collect batteries that are in the same condition. It's important that the battery voltage is the same and that the manufacturing date is close or matches. Sorting the batteries is critical to ensuring a long service life. Next, place the batteries in series. As you can see, the battery consists of an array of 10 batteries in series and 6 in parallel. Secure the batteries with a battery holder and arrange them neatly. We'll arrange the batteries in 13 series and 10 parallel connections. We've neatly aligned the batteries. Check the battery voltage one by one, and make sure they have an average voltage of about 3.776 volts. The average voltage measured is around 3.776 volts. Don't use batteries that have higher or lower voltages than the average. Use a C-clamp to secure the battery, and place a 21700 exclusive insulation sheet to prevent short circuits. Apply Kapton tape to areas where spot welding is not performed. Start the spot welding work on side of first, following the typical battery series connection pattern. Change the battery connection pattern and connect the batteries in series using nickel sheets. Next, we'll use a spot welder to weld the nickel strips. We'll start with one side and perform spot welding. Use a spot welder to weld the nickel sheet, starting with side A and then attaching Kapton tape to protect the nickel sheet. Next, start the spot welding work on side beam, making sure to insulate the surroundings with masking tape. The side B location has a high risk of short circuit, so it's important to insulate the area around it with tape and spot weld it. Make scratches on the nickel sheet and coat it with lead, using a Dremel or tweezers to scratch the nickel sheet bridge. Melt the solder at the scratch location. This is the BMS battery balance connector. Please connect in order starting from negative. Make sure to check the wiring connection. If the order is wrong, the BMS will immediately malfunction. Start connecting the balance cables. Connect them in order by number on each nickel sheet bridge. This is the B negative position of the battery pack. Connect 10 wire to the battery polarity. Connect the wire to each nickel sheet bridge. Press the wire flat with tweezers to attach it. Next, start connecting the positive power cable. Prepare the EVA sheet. Flip the battery pack over. Make scratches on each nickel sheet bridge in the same way. Melt the lead and attach it. Connect the remaining balance cables in order. Solder the wire to the plus positive electrode using a soldering iron. Strengthen weak areas with filament tape. We checked the balance cable connection order with a tester. A voltage of 3.7 volts was measured up to battery block 13. Attach thin double-sided tape. Attach the EVA sheet. BMS connection. Solder the BMSC wire to the XD90 connector. Solder the battery plus positive electrode wire. Solder the black silicone wire to C negative. This is a high current BMS, solder it on both sides. Connect B to the battery, negative polarity. This is a high output BMS that allows continuous current of 100A, solder it on both sides. Prepare the insulation sheet. Attach the BMS with acrylic double-sided tape. Cut the PVC shrink tube. Heat it with a heat gun to shrink it. Cut off the excess that cannot be shrunk anymore. We also made a hole for the battery powered cable. Add a charging connector. We will now connect 14 AWG silicone wire to an XT60 connector. We'll slide a heat shrink tube over the wire. Next, we'll strip the middle of the battery pack wires and connect them. To prevent short circuits, please work on one wire at a time. Make sure the solder penetrates deep enough. Heat it up sufficiently. When the solder is heated up, it will flow nicely under the wire. Wrap it up with insulating tape. Please also follow the same procedure for the black cable. Now, the battery pack is complete. Did you find this video helpful? Please subscribe, like, and leave a comment as it really helps us create more content. Thank you for watching.